This year, Kenya National and East Africa Region IGF meetings focused on addressing and discussing the governance of critical internet resources. The regional East African IGF proposed the development of a working group to strengthen East Africa's CCTLDs. Kenya is also will also be also form a working group. In the area of national cyber security management, the Kenya Communications Amendment Act 2009 recognizes the need to enhance and create public confidence in the use of electronic transactions through the establishment of national cyber security management framework. Further, Kenya chairs the East African Organization's Cyber Security Task Force, whose mandate is to facilitate the establishment of national computer incidents response teams. In this regard, Kenya is currently in the process of establishing national computer incidents response team, whose purpose is to manage cybersecurity issues in the country through a coordinated response to cybersecurity incidences, awareness, creation, research, and provision of cybersecurity advisories, among others. In the area of access, already three undersea fiber optic cables, CECOM, EASY, and TEAMS have landed in Kenya. Kenya is also in the process of putting in place an elaborate national network called the National Optic Fiber Backbone Infrastructure, otherwise dubbed as NOFBI. Satellite links coverage are all in place to serve as backups. Kenya has over 100 licensed ISPs which are interconnected via peering arrangements at the Kenya Internet Exchange Point, that's the KIXP. Further, Kenya has four mobile net telephone operators. The number of mobile telephone subscribers has grown from a meager 20,000 in the year 2000 to about 20 million this year. That's over 1,000% growth. And the number is still growing as we stand here today. This translates to 86% of the population under mobile coverage. The number of internet subscribers stand at about 3 million. Out of these, 2.7 million subscribers are using mobile internet access through GPRS, Edge, and or 3G networks. Mobile money applications like M-Pesa and Zap are used to transfer, receive money across the country, and further 3G and 3G plus technologies are widely enriched in Kenya, and some operators are currently testing 4G pending deployment. By the way, the use of mobile money transfer is also being used by people in the remote areas as banking facilities. Kenya appreciates the value of the UNIGF and would like to take this opportunity to thank the UNIGF Secretariat for facilitating the mandate of the UNIGF for the past 5 years. Special thanks go to all participants from various stakeholders for giving the IGF concept a sense of life.